people can't be defeated, because you know that we can succeed it, because you know policy's not what's needed. Why does U.S. government by the Democratic or Republican? See me, I'm not supportive of it. Back in the day, see they must have thought of it. They had it planned out, so I'ma stand out and make some noise. We gotta straight race it. We out here and you know we must embrace it.
Welcome to Chicago Independent Television, a show independent of corporate and commercial interests. We show Chicago area grassroots media and provide an open space for locally produced media. I'm Mitchell Stripinchik. On today's show, we'll see organizing efforts for an international boycott against Coca-Cola, other organizing efforts by the Latino Union supporting day laborers. We'll join a protest against racism and police brutality following a rebellion in Benton Harbor, Michigan. And we'll visit Madison, Wisconsin to see the Be the Media Conference and the National Conference on Media Reform. Stay with us.
Tired of peace, prosperity, and a clean environment? Ready to lose millions of those bothersome jobs? Want to get your children out of the house and into Iraq? Too many freedoms and opportunities keeping you up at night? Think the rich just aren't rich enough? Then call for my free presidential misinfo tapes now. These misinfo tapes are guaranteed to get you off course and keep you divided. Call 2-800-BUSH-INDUSTRIES. We have an entire cabinet standing by to bankrupt your nation and serve every corporate interest. Call 2-800-BUSH-INDUSTRIES today.
Welcome back to Chicago Independent Television. Students around the world are demanding that their campuses cancel contracts with Coca-Cola. We'll see why in this next video.
Asesinado por los paramilitares y por orden de Coca-Cola.
Quiero decirle a Coca-Cola que seguiremos la lucha hasta el día final en que podamos demostrarle al mundo de que sí podemos vencer estas multinacionales que violan los derechos humanos en todo el mundo. Quiero invitarlos a todos a educar la población civil en contra de Coca-Cola para que no se consuman más estos productos ni los de ninguna otra empresa que viole los derechos humanos.
Coca-Cola asesina, Coca-Cola asesina, Coca-Cola asesina, Coca-Cola asesina, Coca-Cola asesina, Coca-Cola asesina.
You're watching Chicago Independent Television.
Hush, little baby, cry no more. Bush is gonna buy you a foreign war. And if that foreign war goes bad, Bush will take the freedoms you once had. And if those freedoms should be lost, Bush will tell you it's worth the cost, and if the cost seems way too high, that is the point of our lullaby.
Welcome back to Chicago Independent Television. And now a visit with the Latino Union, a Chicago-based organization helping to organize day laborers in Chicago.
My name is Jose Landaverde, and I am currently the director of the Latino Union, but we don't like to use the titles of director in the Latino Union because we believe it that this organization that made decisions collectively. Well, the Latino Union got started in May 21st, 2000, by a group of women day laborers that they were protesting against a day labor agency in Albany, in back of the yards. And that day labor agency was doing a lot of sexual harassment, and selling the workers and not paying the work, and a lot of abuses. We begin campaigns to protest against day labor agencies, and also to organize the workers on the corner, because one of the issues that also the Latino Union begin was because we discovered a lot of police brutality against the workers on the corner, day laborers, people who were looking for jobs on the corners and nobody were doing nothing for them. We have a day laborers that are housekeeping, day laborers. Those day laborers basically are in New York, Los Angeles, and Chicago are a lot, working through housekeeping companies. And we have those day laborers that are housekeeping that go cleaning house to suburban areas or some places. We have the day laborers that are doing manufacturing. Those work through day labor agencies and at the manufacturing level. We have the day laborers that construction, the ones who wait for jobs on the corners, that they are day laborers that wait for jobs on the corners. And day labor is a person who work, basically get paid for the day that he or she work. The universal thing in this and the situation is that they labor work 2 days a week, 1 day a week, sometimes they don't work and they don't get no benefits. They get abused in all different levels.
So today I just wanted to come up here and speak to you guys about some of what your basic rights are as, you know, as workers, as day laborers. Right to be paid the amount of money that you were promised originally when someone picked you up or when you originally agreed with someone to do a certain particular kind of work.
Okay, y algo muy claro es que ustedes sí.
I guess I was saying you can see, you know, the situation here kind of epitomizes these major trends that are going on with globalization from Latin America right now, because almost everybody here is here because they couldn't make a living in their home country, either because of the way the farming industry has been devastated in Mexico or in Central America by NAFTA and by free trade. And also because of the ripple effects that's had even in urban areas in Latin America. So these guys are coming here for those reasons, and then they're ending up working in jobs that, or in a labor market that has been changed and altered for the same reasons, because of NAFTA and because of the way that globalization has affected industry in the U.S. So it's really, it's kind of a cycle.
Oftentimes you may have a case against an employer, a very valid case, but because you don't have any information on who picked you up, where you worked, that kind of identifying information, the Department of Labor is not going to be able to track them down and get your money back for you.
En muchos casos que vemos,
in Chicago, we are facing a lot of misunderstanding by businesses and politicians that they don't want to understand that the reality of the a day labor worker, the reality of the one who is immigrant workers that came to the United States to work with other documents. And then what we have been done so far is holding public hearings, trying to form politicians, educate neighbors, and teach them what the day labor is, in order to create a democratic worker centers where the day labor will be treated with dignity and respect. Yes, and this is the first idea that we had, and this is the our membership. Well, the advantage of this ID card is that most of the time day laborers, they don't get paid a lot. They don't get paid, they don't contractors, they do whatever they want to do with them. And the advantage of this card is that that explains what the Latino Union is. Also, the day labor can show to a contractor when doesn't want to pay them that they are belong to a Latino Union, to an organization. And the contractor will have to pay him, or either way, he's taking the risk. The next day we're gonna be in his house all night, mm-hmm. and he's not gonna sleep. Or we're gonna be protesting, or we're gonna sue them. Or the person has showed that has a respect, that has somebody who is supporting them legally. Mm-hmm. That if you something happening, somebody behind that will search and do a search in the law and find out that this contractor will have to pay him according to the Illinois or the state law. This is an organization with a lot of future, especially for the day labor. The first thing that I hope the Latino Union is going to accomplish is the Democratic Worker Centers. This is the first vision, the dream. Then, if the Latino Union has to adjust to the changes that the sociological changes that Chicago is facing has to pick up some issues that has to fight for. But now I think it's gonna be the workers, just the day laborers, the workers, and with the vision to build worker centers. We recognize that driver license are very important. We recognize that an amnesty and legalization is very important. And we support all those campaigns, and we congratulate all the organizations that are doing, and we give it to them all our support 100%. But our main focus is the worker centers for the day laborers.
Well, what will those be? What are those exactly? The democratic
worker centers? Well, a democratic worker center will be a worker center that is run by the day laborers, that the decisions will be making collectively by the workers, where we will have English classes like this. That we will have a worker rights classes. We will have English classes, GED classes, worker rights classes, skill classes. That we will have and the day laborers will be willing to get organized, and the day laborers will be able with capacity to negotiate their own contracts with contractors and companies and get paid with dignity and respect.
You're watching Chicago Independent Television.
Ever wonder why Bush makes certain decisions? Decisions that foul our air and water, chew up our wilderness, and keep us suckling on foreign oil? Why would he continue to fatten up the wealthy while starving the programs for veterans, seniors, and school children? Or why would he wage a war in Iraq and then give big fat contracts to cronies? Ever wonder if it's really Bush who makes these decisions? Well, we don't mean to insult the pigs, but you get the idea.